everybody. Welcome back to the Super Stream. You know, it's been a couple of days, but I'm excited to get back to it. Hope everybody has been having a good holiday, if you do celebrate it. And for those of you who don't, I hope you had a good 2 days. I had a lovely holiday myself. Got to see a lot of family. And for me, the holiday is not quite over, as my family celebrates Epiphany. Well, we extend the holiday out so that the next family we get to see is on that day. We're not religious, so we don't celebrate that holiday for what it is, but it's an excuse to extend out the holiday for us, which is nice. Hope Santa brought you all the goodies you wanted. I know Santa treated me very well this year, so far. Some of the stuff you'll see in the stream tonight. But I think most of it I'm gonna wait until my Tools of the Trade stream later on this week. So for right now, putting clay into our pot. Gonna make chamomile tonight, which is gonna be fun, I think. If you can't tell, I got a new light. I actually got two of these. I don't know how I can show you. I'll figure it out for the Tools of the Trade video. But got two new lights, and they're going to be used for my display come the time that I start actually looking to sell, but for right now it works beautifully. I know a lot of you have heard me complain about my light situation in my craft room, so good on the hubby for getting the lights I wanted. Video here. For those of you who watched my last video, we used this, I think it's called reindeer moss. I'm gonna use that again because chamomile has that kind of structure of its leaves. Get chamomile leaves would be kind of difficult, so I think I'm going to use this again. Just as a structure for our base. Want a section that's not too thin, but not too thick. The spongy material makes for a great base for leaves or for wispy stems that one would typically have difficulty doing in paper or clay. And I'm not gonna glue it down to our clay because obviously this clay is still soft, but I'm just gonna lay it on top. Have something to work with our mold, with our form. And I'm gonna dig out the size 30 floral wire because we're gonna build some flowers. Some ASMR for you. They made the packaging Bailey proof. Dig out my scissors. Yeah, my hubby got me clay for days. My goodness, he got me so much clay. I hope that I can go through it. He was like, best get crafting. Better get used.
He's right.
How about you guys? Did anybody get anything nice for Christmas? Cutting my stems right now, and now I'm gonna break out an old kit. Don't mind the mess on that. I've got these. Let's see, one that I've already started using. I don't want to break into a new one. Got these old kits from the vegetables I did. Gosh, this light is so great. Oh my gosh. It's got different settings. I can turn down the brightness. So it's almost all, well, not almost all the way off, but certainly less bright. I have it all the way up right now. And then different types of light. Oh gosh, it's so nice. So nice. I'm so excited. I am looking for chamomile. It's itty bitty. So I'm gonna use these itty bitty stars as a base. Pepper leaves. What can I use them for? I don't know. I'll think about that. It's neat going back and seeing things that I could definitely use again, or use for something else. Yeah, especially because I'm doing time. Is that tomorrow? Oh my god. Means I gotta think about it. bunch of these small stars here. Obviously, we're going to keep them white because chamomile is white. Zoom in so you can see that. Look how bright it is! It's so nice! I'm sorry, I'm going to keep being really excited about these lights. Now, chamomile has a lot of leaves. So, you're probably wondering, hey Bailey, why? Why are we doing five pointed leaves? Five pointed petals? They have a lot of petals, I'm sorry, not leaves. Sleepy Bailey. Let's get into view here. Hey Bailey, chamomile has a lot of petals on their flowers. Why are we only doing 5 points? And to that I say, wait, patience, virtue. You'll find out. Don't worry your sweet little head about it. Get there. First off, we're going to switch out our blade because I know it's going to cause a problem if I don't. New blade on our X-Acto knife and not cut ourselves with it, that'd be great. While we do this, and what I'm going to do is try to split these guys into smaller petals. Which we're kind of successfully doing. There we go. So see, they do have cuts in them. So then, if this works correctly, if I put it onto my foam mat and press into it to shape downwards those leaves, those petals. Nope. Theoretically, those petals should separate. I wonder. It's another way I can do this. Let's just keep at this. I wonder if instead, if I cut them. That might be our way to go. However, what I need to do at the same time is layer so that we've got a double layer of. See, now we've got a couple more petals. You can kind of tell. But what I'm gonna do. See if that works. That's a little better. But I think I'm gonna double layer that, maybe with this busted one. Yes, that's what I want. Okay. Just gotta make sure they're off center. Because I don't know if you can see there. I might not even have to cut them. Let's see here. So, one of the things I got for Christmas was I got these little paint trays. Oh, very close. Paint trays, because you know how I'm constantly using tin foil. Well, waste of tin foil, right? So my fiance got me those, and he thought, I guess jokingly thought, that they were for deviled eggs, like handheld deviled eggs trays. I don't know. It was an adorable concept. Got a new blade on my X-Acto knife, so that's good. Let's get rid of that old blade. And let's bring the mat into view so you can see what I'm doing. But nope, needed it for gluing projects and paint projects. Send me out there. So, like I was doing, put in a nice cup. And I'm gonna double layer. One on the end of one of our twigs. stems, as you can see there. Little dab of glue on that guy. Then place that one right on top. Rotate him slightly so we've got some petal action there. Stars are difficult because at some point or another they line up. I don't know how well you can see that. We'll try to. There we go. And we want that cup facing downwards because chamomile has the leaves, or the petals. I keep saying leaves. It's not leaves, petals. They cup downwards. Like daisies are more flat, chamomile cups down. So then, what we'll do is for every daisy we make, we'll just stick them through our leaves, keep them in place, and then we'll eventually add on our little yellow center. Let me go away, box. Let me pull up my reference. Daisies are kind of, chamomile is kind of silly, so it kind of comes out and bends slightly, and then, but the flower points up no matter what. They're kind of stringy. Make a couple more of those. I don't think we need to cut them. I was hoping that would work a lot better, but I don't know that it is. I don't know that it matters. As my mom would say, will they see it running 20 miles an hour through the woods, Bailey Lynn? No. Were they for sale, maybe it would be a different story, but for me, it's fine the way it is. Like I said, if anybody wants to discuss anything that they got for the holiday, I'd love to hear about it. Be the only one chatting about the things that I got. Or who you saw, what you got to do. It's not all about the presents, certainly about family and friends. And I know times are hard right now, so it's difficult to see those people regularly. So I hope you got to see them. Over the holiday. Or if you didn't get to see them in person, did you get to see them over a webcam or talk to them on the phone? I know people don't do that a lot anymore. Which is something I've never personally understood. I like talking on the phone. Never understood that anxiety. I think somebody tried to explain, oh, well, what if I say something stupid? I'm like, you're gonna say something stupid in public, or in person, or with text. You're a human. We say stupid things. And if a person faults you for saying something dumb on the phone, what kind of friend are they and why are you talking to them on the phone? I don't know. I have many anxieties. One of them is not talking on the phone, however. Very vividly remember having a friend in elementary and middle school and high school, and as soon as she got a cell phone, she stopped calling my house phone, because what if my mom answered the phone? He said, well, my mom has always answered the phone, and you've never had a problem with this before. So, what? I don't know. It just confused me. How things so rapidly changed. Suddenly everybody's afraid to talk on the phone. Because what if somebody else answered this phone? And somebody else answered the phone, and you say, hi, this is so-and-so, may I speak to so-and-so? Not hard. And even if it is, even if you do mess up, so what? I find I've put myself on a lot of soapboxes on this channel. I apologize for that. Maybe that's why I can't get 2 more followers. Haha. One of the things is, I can think about what I'm going to say via text. Why? Why do you want to think about it? Tell me your gut reaction to something, man. Tell me how you feel. I don't want a robotic response. I don't want something that's eloquent and posed. I'm not asking you to write a 5-page paper. Just want to know if you want to go out for lunch. Yes, no, maybe not. Think about it. Whatever. I don't know. I don't know. It's because I'm not afraid to be an idiot. I don't know. I'm not saying the people that are, you know, afraid of these things are idiots either. Just not afraid to come off as one. Zoom you back in. Not to the people with noses. Ugh, this light is so great. I can see. It's so nice. My fiance goes, oh, are you going to put both lights on? And I was like, I am going to burn my eyeballs if that's the case. Set to gain their like 15 pounds over the Christmas holiday. Oh no, I lost. Oh, there it is. Flung a flower across the table. Oh, and there's one on my shirt. Weird. Yeah. Is anyone else set to gain that 15 pounds over the holidays because, everybody in my life wants me to. My goodness. I have so many cookies on my table right now. I'm just tempted to freeze them all. Everybody's like, you definitely don't have a dress to fit into next year or anything. Nope. Certainly not. Cookies and breads and... Man, I wish savory dishes were the gift of choice at the holidays. Just give me food. All this dessert is gonna rot my teeth out. I am grateful for cookies because I don't typically do baked goods on my own, but man, so many. There's only so many cookies you can eat before you inevitably get sick. But they're all so good. Another flower. Hey. Get off. updated my craft to-do list challenge. I don't know if I said that already, but I did. So if anybody is in the craft to-do list challenge and is looking to give me a challenge starting the new year, go ahead. Then I will then have more time. I might do a craft today. Who knows? Until I get a new job, who knows? Capable of anything, really. Alright. Bring that back into view. Then we're going to use some of this yellow flocking material again, like what we did for the dill. But this time we're going to use it as our... Let's get it into view. As our pollen centers. Words. Center of the flower. But we want itty bitty pieces. Like that. Bailey, why don't you just paint the centers? Not the same. That's why. Itty-bitty centers for itty-bitty flowers. Because you want it to stick up. Sweaty hands, gross. Okay. Try that again. See that? You want it to stick up from the flower. Because that's how chamomile looks. Not crazy, just attentive to detail. And in miniature, I find detail is everything. apart a couple more pieces. Too tiny. We try using scissors. See if I can zoom in so you can see what the heck I'm doing. Probably make little baggies of these, of just the flowers, because that's what you would use for, say, a chamomile tea or something like that, and then that would be the part I would sell. Maybe brown up the flowers a little bit so they're a little bit drier looking. For people who like a little bit more realism in their dollhouses and not just whatever dried herbs you can fit into a tiny jar. I don't know. I think. For somebody that likes specific dollhouse items, it's not difficult to the point where I couldn't make them. Of my realm of possibility. Alright. So we got a bunch of our little chamomile, as the Brits would say. Flowers. Very pretty. Now we'll start sticking them. Give it a little bend here and there. Except this does not bend nicely. Hold off on the bending until they go into the pot. Then, how busy chamomile plants are with flowers, so it's really nice to be able to just have a million flowers and it not look silly. Say though, I need something stronger than tweezers. The wire is just too thin that it keeps slipping out of the grip. Thank you. probably add about 20 more flowers and it would still look decent. But they do all look a little windswept because they're all leaning a certain way. There we go. It's a little better. Last one. And that would be our chamomile plant, and so I'm gonna go bake this. Pretty cool, I think. I think an up-close picture would give us a better... Get out of here. It would give us a better view of it, but yeah. Pretty easy. Surprisingly easy now that I'm looking at the finished product, because I was definitely not sure how that was going to work out today. Oh, I have wire sticking out the bottom. But I'm gonna trim them off real quick. Because I'm not gonna want to do it after this bakes, because if I do it after it bakes, I'm gonna have trouble handling it with the reindeer moss because it'll be all brittle. We saw that yesterday with, not yesterday. What day was that? Friday? Thursday? 23rd. With our dill. Because we used the same material and it got very brittle after it baked. So, chamomile plant. For a nice tea. If you would. Pretty happy with it. Let me go bake this and then I'll go over my spiel. Look how bright it is. Oh my gosh, I can't believe it. I'm sorry. I'm just very excited. For those of you new to the stream, welcome, 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 and thank you for joining me tonight. As you saw, we made chamomile plant. I've been making herbs since December 19th, and I plan on doing it until December 29th. For anyone new, I am a 1/12 miniature dollhouse artist and collector, and I'm... Sorry, thought I had to do a mom thing for a second. Nope. Yes, so my streams are usually Sundays, 7:30 p.m. Eastern time, but I'm trying to push for affiliate in this coming week before the new year. I think I can achieve it, I just need 2 more followers, so if you know anybody that is willing to hit the follow button and chat with me in the stream, I'd really appreciate it. That being said, I typically stream my dollhouse setups or making things like you saw tonight. I do holidays. The past year I've been making a lot of vegetables, plants, things like that, but in the coming year I plan on doing a lot more holiday stuff, I think, and branching out into other creations But if you have any suggestions for the stream, or you want to see something, you want me to go back over something, show you like what kind of materials I used, or specify a little bit more on something I made in the past, I would happily do so. All you got to do is reach out to me, and you can do that via my suggestions box or privately message me on any of my social media accounts. As for my social media accounts, I have a blog that I upload maybe once a month. That's blueberryhollowminiatures.wordpress.com. If you are interested in more of my quick updates, you can check out my Facebook or my Instagram. That's Blueberry Hollow Minis. Miniatures, sorry. On both of those. And my TikTok is Blueberry Hollow Minis. I don't update my TikTok as much as I should. But hopefully in the new year I'll have more opportunity to do that, more energy to do that. If you want to check out my past videos, you can check out my YouTube by looking up Bailey Carr, Blueberry Hollow Miniatures. Any of that should come up. And if you're watching this on my YouTube and want to check out my Twitch, that's also Blueberry Hollow Miniatures. All of those websites should link to one another, so if you find one, you should be able to find the other. You can also probably Google me at that point. I'll come up on at least one social media system. Like I said, if you have any suggestions, please let me know. I'd really love to hear from you guys, because at this point I'm flying by the seat of my pants as to what I'm doing and what I create. If you want to be in charge of the content that you see in a more direct way too, I have what's called a craft to-do list challenge. It is a Google document that you send me your email address. I promise I will not use your email address for anything else. But that Google Doc has a list of everything that, in my head, I want to get done, whether for myself or for my upcoming sales. Or even for just like, you know, Christmas projects, birthday presents, things like that. It's just my to-do list for all of my craft stuff. What it is you leave a comment, you leave your name on one of the items you want me to get done, and I try to do that project in a week's time. And that, you know, helps motivate me to get that project done. It helps me get that project done, and I get a little boost of like, yay, serotonin, I got it done for you, and that makes me happy. And then you get whatever you get out of that, which I'm not gonna judge. You know, some people like telling other people what to do. That's why there's bosses in this world, right? is what it is, man. Like, no judgment there. Also helps you see more of the content that you want to see, and helps you be a part of Blueberry Hollow in a way, so that's great. So if you want to be a part of that, just privately message me your email address and I will add you to the Google document. My goals for the upcoming year are to start selling. I am officially a business in the state of New Jersey, which is great. And totally unexpected from when I first started all of this. Like, if you were to ask me, you know, 20 years ago when I started collecting miniatures, if I thought I would ever sell miniatures, I would tell you, you were out of your mind. Because, like, I did not think it would be possible, and I certainly didn't think things that I make would be something that people want to buy. So, I mean, I'm still not quite sure of it, but fingers crossed, maybe I can at least make enough to, you know, pay for my convention costs and maybe buy myself a little something nice here and there. Seems like people have some interest in it. At least enough that I have 48 followers that watch my stream, which is great. Like I said, I'm two people away and a couple of chatty people in my stream away from getting affiliate. Certainly not something that was the main goal, but certainly an achievable one at this point. So if you know two more people that, you know, Even if they want to drop me a follow and not watch my stuff, that'd be great. I'd really appreciate it either way. And like I said, put that stuff in the oven. Should be done here in a couple minutes. I bake my polymer clay at 250 degrees Fahrenheit for anywhere from 5 to 25 minutes, depending on the size of the piece. Typically, I keep it around 10 minutes because my pieces are rather small. I know there hasn't been a lot of chatty people in the chat tonight, but if you have any questions, I'm always happy to take questions. I'm always happy to hear from you guys. Currently, just my pretzel rocks has been talking to me all night. So.
Very much alike.
Yeah. That's about it for tonight. I don't even think I'm gonna put soil on that. Typically, in my other plants, I've put soil on top of the clay to make it look more like a plant, but I think our foliage kind of covers it enough that it's not really a big issue. So I'm gonna clean up, but if anybody wants to chitty chat at me, I'm more than welcome to. Happy to hear about your holidays, or whether you're excited for the new year, if you have any resolutions that you're gonna stick to. Oh, that's right, I didn't even tell you guys what I'm doing tomorrow. Good. What am I doing tomorrow? I'm pretty sure it's time. Give me 1 second and I'll find my list. There it is. Yeah, tomorrow's gonna be time. That's gonna be ridiculous, but you know, I've gotten through the other 6 herbs, so I'll find a way to do this one too. Time is just time. Oh boy. Okay. And then the 28th will be cilantro. The 29th is going to be tarragon. And the 30th, like I said, is going to be a tools of my trade. Ooh, there it is. It's done. Tools of my trade and an ask me anything, at which point hopefully we'll have more people in the chat. I'd love to hear your questions about literally anything for the dollhouse or me or what have you. Really excited for that one because I've got a lot of tools and stuff that I use. Like, I'll find any reason to use something. If you've got any questions, like I said, you can always ask me now, but you can also save them for the Ask Me Anything. I'm really excited about that one. So, I hope you'll be at that one. Let me go get the plant so I can show you one last view of it before we're done for the night. Hot. I also bake my polymer clay on polyfill. That way we don't ever get any weird little press marks on the clay. And I'll tell you what, it is one of the most brilliant things that has ever been suggested to me. Alright. Maybe I'll add a little bit of soil there because that is a little sketchy. Can't see the soil there. But now, let me see if I can take some things away, show you the work. If it would focus, that'd be fantastic. Nope. Oh, I had it. Ah, there it is. Ah, perfect. Okay. See, I've got that little bit of soil, that little bit of clay there. I might cover that up with some soil. But that is our chamomile. And it looks like chamomile, so I'm happy with it. The only one I haven't been happy with so far has been the dill, but every time I look at it, I go, yeah, it kind of looks like dill. Looks dill enough that I don't mind it so much. So, there's our plant. Oh, penny for scale. That's what we got tonight. I hope you guys enjoyed the stream. I really did. And I hope to see you guys tomorrow. Probably a little bit earlier. Maybe 6:30? Maybe 7? Hopefully not as late as I started tonight. But everybody have a great night, and I will see you tomorrow. See you later. Bye-bye.